Wherever you are, blessings of others accompany you. All individuals and all things respond to you according to the touch of your words or of your hands. Bless your home with the light of love in the form of self-denial and work, and your home will bless you with gratitude and joy. Bless the tree of your house with the gift of your affection. The tree of your house will bless you with the perfume of the flower and with the richness of the fruit. However, if you curse your companion each day with the whip of censure, you will receive the sorrow and mistrust. If you condemn the animal who shares your domestic climate with hunger and flogging, you will get rebellion and harshness. In truth, you cannot bless evil expressed in cruelty, but you must bless the victims so that they may be strong in order to extinguish it. It will not be fair to bless the sickness that afflicts you, but it is indispensable to bless your diseased organs so that it may be more safely readjusted, expelling the disease which sometimes imposes bitterness and unbalance on you. Do not curse even by thought. The aggressiveness or destructive idea is corrosive in our mouth, shadow in our eyes, hallucination in our arms, and misfortune in our life. Bless the hand that hurts you, and the hand that hurts you will learn how to avoid the remnants. Bless the word that insults you, and you will avoid the extension of retaliation. Bless the difficulty, and the difficulty will reveal precious lessons to you. Bless suffering, and suffering will regenerate you. Bless the stone, and the stone will serve in building. Do not forget the divine master of blessing. Jesus blessed the manger and made it the luminous cradle of the nascent gospel. He blessed Peter, weakened and faltering, transforming him into a vigorous fisherman of souls. He blessed the obscure Magdalene and therein formed the sign of human sublimation. He blessed Lazarus, dead, and gave him life. And finally, he blessed the cross itself, carving the victory of the imperishable resurrection. Bless the earth wherever you pass, and the earth will bless your passage forever.
Feeling the blessings of this sacred moment, we visualize illuminated hands shine upon us, healing energies. Let us feel the blessings and open ourselves to renew. Dear Mother, Father God, we thank you for the countless lessons that remind us of our divine essence. May we become as aggressive, more embracing, less hurtful, more loving. Already thankful for this opportunity, we think of those who are living moments of desperation or abandonment. May they receive the helping hand that relieve their hearts from anguishes and sorrows. to new learning opportunities so they can get out of their desperation, they can get out of their hopelessness, fully aware that they are loved unconditionally by you. And may this hour that you grant us be of deep healing. May we all be easy in the hands of the good spirit doctors who are here present. May we feel their loving embrace and continue our progress in the certainty that we are awaited in the next steps of our evolution. We feel your protection and the inspiration, so we kindly ask to grant us permission to begin this moment of treatment of our souls and consequently our bodies, and so be it. Today, before we begin, the message that the Good Spirits asked us to think about is this one by Sister Sheila. Sister Sheila used to be a nurse in her last incarnation in the World War, and later becoming acquainted of the Good Spirits in the team of Dr. Rosario de Menezes and others, she joined forces and started working with Chico, Xavier and many others around the world. So today, her message is blessed always. But it's not simple, right? Because we stumble and then we curse. That's natural. It's almost like a defense mechanism. So it's not that we need to punish ourselves saying, oh, I'm a bad person because I still curse. No, she's not saying that. But she's saying, you know, you can condition yourself to a different direction. Who teaches us that? Have we learned it in our childhood? Bless everything? I doubt. Even if our parents were the most diligent parents, it's new. All this knowledge is really at the vanguard of humanity. It's so new that when we read it through, we're like, really? Can I do this? Should I do this? But isn't God already blessing everything? Why do I need to bless? Well, because God made us co-creators. He didn't say, I am the creator and you are, puppet? No, because that's how many people feel. That's why they push away God. They're like, I'm not a puppet. I don't believe in God. God doesn't. There's any force in the universe does not control me. I control myself. So that's why many people push it away, because they feel that believing in God, having a relationship with God, means that we're less. Well, not that we're less, we're part of it. Not part of God, but part of the creation of God. But God has made us so powerful that even Jesus came to us and said, you're gods. He meant, you're co-creator, you cannot be passive. You're part of it. You cannot sit back and relax and enjoy the show. Because you are making a show. Oh, really? Oh, that's why my life is going to this direction, because I'm making it happen and I didn't notice? Yes. So that's why Emmanuel, when Chico Xavier, 17 years of age, said, I want to help. I love these teachings. How can I help? Discipline, discipline, discipline. What does that mean? Be aware that you are co-creating at each thought, at each feeling, at each word, at each action. So much so that nowadays, in an era of social media, if you say one bad word at the wrong time, bye-bye to your freedom. Because you may be in jail for quite a while. It doesn't need to be anything exceptional, but the wrong word at the wrong time. That's the power of ourselves. And now we're getting to know that you cannot boast anything just because you're wrong. You cannot say anything just because. You cannot do anything just because you like, because in this day and age, more than ever, we're learning that whatever we do has consequences. No longer we're going to be left to our whims indefinitely, abusing our bodies, abusing others. Nowadays, for example, eating. Eating nowadays has consequences that have never had before, because the food industry is contaminated. It creates toxins in the body just by drinking milk, because in the milk they put 10,000 things. It's no longer milk. It's something else. It's no longer milk. Bread no longer is bread. Because they put a lot of other enrichments that really the body doesn't need, and many people have food allergies like they've never had before. So each and everything we do has a stronger impact. Why? I remember asking Divaldo Franco this question in 2006. I said, Divaldo, why this much food allergy nowadays, especially the new generations? And he said, themselves. So actually, cut it down. Yeah, learning to eat less, to indulge more of us. I know it's not easy. But nowadays, life is teaching us. At the door. Thank you. I heard something. So, what we know is that everything is pushing us to greater understanding, to greater self-management. I wouldn't say self-control. It's about self-management. So we need in this era. Dramatic consequences for little actions. How many kids we've heard there in school? People in the past could fight, nobody would know, and maybe people would just buffer it up with something. Nowadays, it happens on social media. It's viral. A kid said something to about somebody else. What is it saying to us? You are creating your life with God. That's why Sister Sheila is telling us, bless your life, because you're the co-creator of your life. You're not a puppet of God. I'm not a puppet of God. God is counting on my will to create the life that I want. But then you may be asking, and I ask myself too, we ask ourselves, how do I do it? Where does it begin? It begins in the mind. And that is already scientifically proven. If I don't visualize this new life, it's not gonna happen. Oh, Vanessa, it's so hard. I know, but you're not alone. And there are people ahead of us. Observe people who are ahead of us and say it's possible. There are people in this planet who know how to live a whole day without saying a bad word. I know some of these people. No bad word. They don't gossip. They don't talk bad about anybody. They're not perfect. But that mistake, they don't incur. Oh, if that's my issue, think. It's possible. Relationships. Oh my gosh, it's so hard. Majority of relationships are not simple. But they are true bonds of affection on the earth that are real, respectful, kind, and loving. Observe. Search for it. That's why Emmanuel said, seek the good. It exists. God is so wise that he placed people ahead of us and people who are still falling behind. Those we need to help. The other ones we need to emulate. So that's why Sister Sheila is telling us, wherever you are, bless your life so the blessings of others accompany you. Bless everything. The bed that we sleep in. You come to DC, you see the homeless, and you're like, I can't imagine. If I end up this way, don't visualize it. But think about all others who ended up this way. Why? Mostly because of obsession. It's like this. They are living a life, they messed up. And then their spouses, their family members said, you're no longer living with us. And then they have one relative, one, that says, okay, you can come with me. But they say, no, thank you, because they don't get along. They prefer to be in a shelter. What is it? Because when Chico Xavier was 4 years old, his mother died. He had several siblings. The only choice for him was to be with his godmother. She was a bad person. She became better, as far as we know, after so many years. But she wasn't a good person. She was abusive. She would spank him. She would make him do things that were outrageous. As a medium, little as he was, he could see his mother, who came from the spiritual realm, and the mother said, and said, Mom, I can't be here. And the tiny city, super tiny, it's almost like a village. He could have run away, gone to somebody else's home. And the mother said, no, stay where you are, be obedient to her. Sometimes life is cornering us and we want to run away. That's the law of preservation. But you shouldn't run away to be in the streets. So we need to learn how to bless our houses and seek the good where there seems to be only difficulties. Or we're never going to live with anybody. Because we're always going to encounter problems, shortcomings. The same for jobs. Oh yes, a better job is always a good option, but sometimes life tells you, stay there. But don't stay there cursing the job, cursing the boss, cursing the colleagues. If you're more illuminated, illuminate it. Because sometimes we feel so superior, but we're cursing those whom we think we are inferior. So then we ask, are we so superior? So if God wants everyone to progress, he wants us to be that light where others are. Let us be that light and bless. So she says, If you curse your companion each day with the whip of censure, you will receive the sword of mistrust. Some people are like this at work, at home, with their children, with their friends. Their friends put the paper in an angle. They're like, oh, you want to put it in the angle? They're always criticizing. Always criticizing. What do they expect? That people are going to say, yes, my dear, I did. People are going to be resentful. And then you're bringing to you that resentment because you're always putting people down, criticizing them. You didn't do it right. That's wrong. That's wrong. Buzzing, 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 buzzing people. So for us, we bless. And there is one notion that only Spiritism brings to us, which is the law of justice. Justice according to the superior knowledge. And the answer is striking, because they said to be just is to respect people's rights. People want to use drugs. Does that mean we're going to put up with their drug addiction? Not necessarily. Because we know every time there is drug addiction, it affects the whole family. Does that mean we're going to be there being abused day in, day out? No. But it means they have the right to be who they are. And that's why in the book, Renunciation, Alcyon, who is a superior spirit, who loves this man, but knows that he is not ready. She renounces to be with him, respecting his way of being instead of doing the opposite. I'm going to change you. Because then we're not being just. Whenever we impose ourselves onto others, we're not being just. Jesus never did it, and he is our most powerful guiding one. That's why in Spiritism, we never, ever condemn separations, divorces. Why? That's the way to respect people's way of being. If they want to go, go. If they prefer that way, so be it. We're not going to tell them, you have to stay here. Because marriage is for eternity. It's not. It's a companionship for a while. Sacred, but it depends on two people. And if the other one is not on the same page and they prefer otherwise, what can we do? We're not going to enforce the marriage on them. And that's justice. Let people go their way and bless and say, I'll learn the lesson as I leave each and every day. And bless the opportunity we've had, knowing that we are not twins, conjoined twins, to be connected forever, because that doesn't exist. Bless, do not curse even by thought, she says. You know, when we're driving and people cut us off, in D.C., Northern Virginia, but then breathing in and out. So that's a good technique, because we need practical tools. We know the rules, but we need to know what to do. So the bottom line of it all practicing relaxation breathing. The more we practice it, it's gonna become second nature when we need the most. Like for example, when we talk to our children. And they are doing something, and then we're like, oh my gosh, I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say it. There will be a day we won't even express it because we'll be faster in managing it. But before we do it, breathe in and out deeply, slowly, deeply, slowly, and tell ourselves everything is okay. This shall pass and the card passes by. And that's fine. You're waiting for your promotion. It doesn't happen. Everything, there's an order in the universe. Maybe God is intervening, because if you got that promotion, you would lose yourself in 10,000 things. You shouldn't. God knows. So blessing the blessings in disguise. Blessing the turns of life that are unexpected. She even says about physical illnesses, it will not be fair to bless the sickness that afflicts you, but it is indispensable to bless your diseased organ so it may be more safely readjusted, expelling the disease which sometimes imposes bitterness and unbalance. So I go there, like talking to a pet, and say everything's okay, because the body is the most important pet we'll ever have. If you take good care of your dog, of your cat, the parrot, the bird, the turtle, but we don't take good care of this pet, which Andre Luiz says is formed by little animals, those cells, then we're not doing our main job. The main job is not going to the job. As an incarnate being, it's taking care of the body. Who teaches us that? Nobody does. When we take a shower, that's an easy time to do it. Thank you. Soaping ourselves and thanking ourselves. And showering ourselves, visualizing this illuminated blessing. The healing energies coming and changing the energies, exchanging. As Kardec says in the book Genesis, getting rid of the unhealthy molecules so we can be permeated by new healthy ones. And thus, we are co-creating with God, blessing everything, looking at the pluses of life instead of the minuses. Some people, they say, oh my gosh, I only have one pencil. They want 10. What for if you have one hand to write? Unless you write with two, then you need two. But 10, and that's the area we're living, especially in the United States, where there is overabundance. Not even abundance, it's overabundance. We have 3 coffee makers. We use one, and the other ones we're keeping. One day if I need for a different coffee, I'm gonna use that one. Wow. Anchors. The extra are anchors to our energy. And then we're like living our days like dragged. I don't know what is happening to me. Life is so heavy. Well, look back. You have 10,000 anchors, all the superfluous things that you have at home. No wonder it's hard to fly high or even to fly. Because we're so anchored in our attachments. And then we have super storages. You're not going to use it, give it away. Oh, but tomorrow, in 10 years, I may. In 10 years, there are people who need it. And you promised to help them, so you don't recall whose name they were.
So that's the story of a woman. A woman who promised something. She came to Chico Xavier.
She was very wealthy. And Chico, the advice of the good spirits was, yeah, create an orphanage. She did. She admitted first the first 20 children. And people started being so admiring her for the work, saying, you know, let's expand it. So she stopped admitting things, started expanding. But she was so thorough about the details of the expansions that year after year, she wouldn't admit any other kid. After 20 years, she still, well, the kids were already grown up, and she thought she did well. So one day, she came to the meeting and asked, am I doing right? Did I do right? Because many people nurse, you give one meal to a homeless, wow, we become saints now. So that must be important for us. That's a highlight thing. Highlight it. Don't forget it. Because that's the final message before the treatment. So the message is, the spirit says, hey, Mom, I'm so sorry, but before you reincarnated, you promised to help 80 spirits. You helped 20. She was shocked. She was like, what about the other ones? They are no longer children. You can help others now, but the ones already passed. Sometimes we think we're doing great, but we forget that God doesn't stop. He doesn't do one beautiful work and stop saying, I'm going to relax. And that's what we do. We do something beautiful at home, and then we spend 7 days doing nothing. We needed to learn how to be rhythmic in the good. Slow but sure and always, always constant. That's the rhythm of life. Life doesn't go like this. Stop. The flow of life is soft. And constant and gradual, like the font, the spring of water that turns into later a river and later into the ocean, joining forces. Little by little, but constant. So blessing all. So we are asked today to revisit our lives, declutter from the mind to the bodies, to our homes, to our lives, and bless. It always begins in one step, and from there on it's a cascade of events. We begin wherever possible, as Joana de Angelis says in the book Happy Life. But there's so much to be done. Begin with one of the 10,000 things. And then naturally you're gonna find less imprisoned, freer to move forward and keep declaring our lives, blessing our lives as we eat, as we pay the bills. Because if you can pay the bill, that's good for you. You have the money. There are people who have bills, don't have money. Oh, please, I have a bill, don't have money. Bless that difficulty, because that's going to give you a challenge for some learning experience. You're going to learn a new job, a new skill. You need to be open. And then I have a diagnosis. emotionally more controlled, be more positive. The final question. Many people are not positive because they think, what if it doesn't work? They are afraid of being positive and be frustrated. That's why we've been telling people, watch the movie, I Feel Pretty. It's a comedy. I Feel Pretty. It's in the Redbox, and I don't know where else, but I Feel Pretty. It's exactly about this. People who are afraid. What if I feel it, but I look in the mirror and I am disappointed? And sometimes, what if I feel so lucky, but I look in the mirror of life and I don't see this luck? So, you know, I'm so afraid of frustration and disappointment that I prefer not even to think about the positive. Well, the news is this, if we keep in that direction, it's never gonna change. Life changes when we change our thoughts, when we change our feelings. I need to be the first investor of my life. I know people who come to me and say, I want to find investors. I say, but do you invest in yourself? Me? Yeah, you need to be your first investor. If you don't believe in yourself, you think others are going to believe in you? Oh, but if they believe in me, then I'll believe in myself. Or well, they won't believe in you if you don't believe in yourself. Well, the good news is God believes in us. Up right now, He's investing in us. By keeping us alive, not only in the physical body, because the discarnates are not at disadvantage, they are also being invested by God in their own existence, in our existences. So if God is our greatest investor, do you need Nike? Well, maybe when incarnated, we do, right? But they will only sponsor us when we sponsor ourselves. And to sponsor ourselves, we need to bless our lives. So today we're invited to get rid of our guilt and say, who hasn't done mistakes in this life? If today's the day I want to shift, so be it. It's in God's hands. But I won't be sabotaging myself. I will not be the one that God is saying, go ahead, you deserve a better life. And I'm like, me? Are you talking to me? Yes, to you. You deserve a better life. But think about what better life is for you. Because for God, there's no limit. Materially and spiritually. Sister Sheila wraps up by saying, bless the earth wherever you pass, and earth will bless your passage forever. So right now we're going to pass to the second part. We're going to say bye to the friends, blessing the friends over the internet and Kardec Radio. And now we're going to do our second part.